In today's tutorial, you'll learn how to design this flat illustration in just a few steps. The first step is to start with a sketch. The theme of this illustration is of a woman standing on the window sending a message. If you want to follow along with this tutorial, you can download the sketch and exercise files for free. The link is in the description of this video. Once you have the sketch, open up Illustrator and place it on a new artboard, and with the sketch selected, lower its opacity to 20%, and from the layers panel, create a new one on top where you'll actually place the sketch, and afterwards lock the layer up so you won't draw on it. Now it's time to trace it using the pen tool. Start with the main body shape, and once you define it, take the direct selection tool, select the top corners and round them up. You can do that by dragging on the small rounded anchors you see inside the shape, just like that. Continue adding shapes on top of each other, and try to also think about layering and positioning of each individual one. For example, we'll need to send this element to the back, so let's use the command left bracket shortcut to do so. Once you finish with the basic shapes of the body, it's time to define the windows. Apply a random color and then set it behind the body. With the pen tool, you can start adding shapes that will be used to actually split that main one in multiple ones and divide it. With both shapes selected, go to the shape builder tool, and while holding down the alt key, remove the unnecessary parts. For the window blinds, one cool trick if you want to duplicate elements faster is to use command D after duplicating a shape. That will space them out and provide consistency. Take the rectangle tool, as it's time to create the background shape, send it to the back, and now would be the perfect time to start adding colors to your illustration. I found this color scheme on a dribbble shot, I sampled them and adjusted them a bit, but I think this will work great for this illustration. You can find the color codes in the description of this video and of course in the exercise files. To add some variety of shapes and style to the illustration, I'd recommend defining any detail, like the glasses and face features, through stroke pads that have an empty feel. Just like in my previous videos, I like using these kinds of pads to also add some kind of separation between similar types of shapes and to add contrast to them. Let's add some of the pads at the bottom as well and separate the two hands. Since they have the same color applied, it would be pretty hard to understand what's going on if you don't have some kind of separation defined. Also add these two hair curls, and as you can see from the stroke panel, use these settings by adding rounded corners and caps to get good looking stroke pads. With the hand shape selected, make a copy, and using the knife tool, slice the bottom part in order to create some dimension and shade the body. Try to go smoothly with it, as it tends to get a cleaner pad done, and imagine that the light is coming from above and how that would cast a shadow on these types of elements. You can then duplicate the background shape, right click on it, and bring it to the front of the illustration. Go to the effects window, and from the texture effect tab, click on grain. Play around with the intensity and contrast till you find something that looks good, and then go to the transparency tab, choose the overlay blending mode and lower its opacity to 10%. This will make the illustration look like it's been printed and give it some texture. Here's the final look of the flat illustration. If you've enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to like it so more people could see it and subscribe for more. Let me know in the comment section if this was helpful and enjoy the rest of your day. See you in the next video. Bye!